all seems to indicate, you know, that they're predicting an 8% growth rate off the back of a global slump. If you just go and look at the way, you know, the pricing for things like iron ore and coal is being determined at the moment, I think that's all on the back of big pushback from Chinese buyers. You know, now I don't think the final word on pricing has been spoken. You know, but certainly a mechanism that was there for many, many years has been pushed aside in favor of something else, you know, not finally signed off and agreed on into the future. But it would appear like they will be in this market and will be driving the demand side of things for quite a few years to come. And then, you know, the other big players just sort of sitting behind them, the Indias, the Brazils, those, you know. If you look at the rate of growth of a company like Vale, it's unbelievable. So, you know, South America might be a story on its own. It's an effort to put in a more robust royalty type arrangement. We don't necessarily think that's the case, because, you know, if you look at the way this is structured at the moment, it effectively makes the Australian government a partner in the business, so that, you know, if it goes backwards, you know, they actually refund and they chip in, you know, to the coffers. So I think what this perhaps might have done is might have opened the debate in the rest of the world as to, well, you know, is mining paying its fair share? And you know, certainly that's been the argument in the Henry report. So I don't think there would be a direct impact in South Africa. We have a royalty bill that's been debated quite robustly and is being implemented at the moment. But, you know, that perhaps is where we might see some overhang. I'm not convinced that, you know, we'll see significant investment into Africa as a result of that.